Morning. Just check how it works. Okay. Yeah. So dependence on contribution, that's the subject of this talk. While preparing it, I asked myself a few questions. The first question was, what's my relationship to open technologies? How did it evolve? So let's to begin with, we'll jump back in 2003. I started using open source, mostly software, because I figured out that there was free alternatives to the cracked software I was using at that time. On top of that, I was using HTML, JavaScript, PHP, MySQL for NetArt and generative stuff I was doing. At that time, I didn't really bother about sharing what I was doing. I was kind of isolated, and people around me were not really interested in this, in what I was doing. After asking myself what's the point too many times, I came to a point where I did delete everything. I delete all my websites, everything on my hard drives, USB keys, end of the story. I did nothing for about a year, until someone pointed me to the work of Burak Arıkan, and that's how I jumped into processing. So that a great software with a lot of documentation, tutorials, books, many libraries to do like so many things. But what I did discover when I jumped into processing is, by scratching the surface, I found a great community, an hyperactive community of really smart people. All this sped up by Twitter communication. Making and creating things was made easy. Things that I never could have done alone, and things that I could never have think of, like interfacing software with hardware, like BlinkLED from processing, using a remote for something else than playing tennis. So it was really a new start for me. So I managed to recover about 80% of my work by using a recovery software, started experimenting in different ways with these new technologies, so from processing to Arduino to something else. And I built my little Twitter network, and I really met great people online, offline. But these people were not like untouchable, unreachable superheroes, but people who share, people I care about when I see like personal news that they post on the social networks. I was part of something, and not only on the technological point, but also it also involved activism, politics, being aware of things which happen in the world which are not always in the news. By standing in the middle of this community, not that I am the center of the world, but just that I see people around me, I was given a chance to really contribute, share, and benefit from the work of other people. Each person is, to me, a hub to a set of information, knowledge, technology. When in 2011 I decided to create in France the Graffiti Research Lab, so for those who don't know about it, the first Graffiti Research Lab was created in 2005 by James Podoli and Evan Rhodes in New York, during a residency at ABIM, and a few years after they did publish something on Instructables to get people to create their own graffiti buster slab around the world. So this one I'm talking about was created in France 3 years ago. And in 1 month, we managed to gather people to work together, artists, designers, graphers, people into electronic, into software. And in 6 months, we already had a bunch of projects published and documented, including, for instance, maybe you saw it, NTQ, which is for near tile quality. It's a graffiti printer which works with 7 spray cans, each individually controlled with an Arduino, where you can upload a message. So, what did it work so well? It did work because without knowing each other, we had a lot in common. We had this culture of open source and really complementary skill with overlaps, and we didn't have a huge gap to fill to be able to work together. Clearly, we couldn't have done so many things without open technologies, because it saves us time, it saves us money, and it also boosts our creativity. That's not a strong dependency, but that's a clear dependency. It's our toolbox. It allows us to experiment, prototype, create. It also facilitates the transmission of our work, because we can, once we publish something, people can find the parts, can modify what we do, and it serves everyone. So, how do we contribute? We contribute by sharing, documenting, educating people, and also spreading the word. In the social networks, in conferences, workshops. What we tend to do is to change the way people think by taking them to do it yourself, recycle, upcycle. I think that's quite important because, for instance, during the last year, I spent a lot of time in a school doing presentation to teenagers. And when I was showing them videos or software or hardware, they really liked it. But the thing that is that when they asked questions about this project, this was just, does it exist as an application for my smartphone, or how much does it cost? And they never really bothered about knowing how to build it, or how to use it, or change it. So I think we really have it's our responsibility to change that, to drag people outside of consumerism, and to think by themselves, and not really be passive. So that's it. Thank you, because there are many people in the room. I don't know everyone, but there are a lot of people I can thank for what you're doing, because I'm using it. That's all.